I am a political comic. It's buffeted by the winds of fate. Trust me, sometimes there's nothing going on and I'm screwed. But not now. And I have so many people to thank. Most of them Republicans. No, it's just been such a fecund year. It's not just me. Pat Robertson said that this field of Republican candidates is too extreme. Pat Robertson said that. Which is like having a drug intervention hosted by Lindsay Lohan. And Charlie Sheen is driving a van. I'm serious, I get the feeling that Obama could discover a cure for cancer and Republicans would complain he's anti-big pharmaceutical. And of course, the ridiculous charge, he was born in Kenya. No, he wasn't. He was born in Honolulu, in a manger. No. And was visited by the three Haoles. Presented him with gifts of gold, frankincense, and pork. Face it, there are some people, not here, not far away, Martinez, you know, there are some people who are never going to get used to the fact we're now being governed by a black guy living in public housing. He's not getting much help from either side. One of the reasons they throw all this stuff at him is because he's so smooth. And he is, you know, there's not the hint of a whisper of a scintilla of a shadow of a scandal. I mean, Clinton was a corpulent womanizer. You know, Bush had the DUIs and the DTs and the STDs and the TMJ and the ADHD. Actually, had ADHDDD. But Obama, and you know, they tried. He's smooth, man. He's like chamois on chrome. He's got less friction than rayon pajamas on silk sheets in zero gravity. Hey, no matter what you think of Obama's policies, you've got to admire his ability not to get involved in them. Obama's pissed off both the left and the right. That's what's funny, because the progressives are all up in arms, you know. They weren't doing their little sad puppy thing. You didn't pass the rainbows in every pantry. And the way you listen to them, you think that he's a radical jihadist trying to drag America into the socialist sinkhole that is Canada. So one side sees him as Malcolm X, the other side, Urkel. Oh, they're useless. They are. He can't even accuse the Democrats of being afraid of their own shadow because they don't cast one. I doubt if 3 out of 10 Democrats could escape from a stalled escalator in under an hour.
Escalators moving. Elevators.
I think that's the whole reason they were so intent on passing that stem cell bill. They're depending on that research to generate a spine. No, you can't woo and applaud at the same time. You're at the border, it's time to declare. Seriously? Seriously, Democrats aren't even aware they're in the middle of a war. Republicans are attacking with torches and pitchforks, and the Democratic response is to introduce legislation to reform pitchfork safety standards. First book was called Going Rogue. She sold 1.5 million copies, 85% to people who hadn't bought a book in 5 years. That's true. She's queen of the illiterati. She's selling books to people who don't read. You can see why she got a second book deal. Publishers love her. They never considered targeting the non-reading segment. Sunglasses for those born without ears. Doesn't matter if it's conservative or liberal, Republican, Democrat, male or female, they all do the same thing, the same dance. First, it wasn't me. Okay, might have been me. It only happened once. Maybe a couple times. I gotta go. It happened with Ensign and Bitter and Sanford and the unfortunately named Congressman Wiener. That was his own damn fault. You get to choose how other people pronounce your name. He didn't have to go with Wiener. He could have done the Boner Boehner thing. Speaker of the House, John Boehner, has 11 brothers and sisters. They're all boners. Lousy name for a politician. Apt for a Democrat, perhaps. Or he could have gone ho-hog, which is what I would have done. Yes, we spell it W-E-I-N-E-R, but it's pronounced Schultz.